town, or Chalfont St Giles, a little town about 35 miles northwest of London, to realise who they were. and then we moved a couple of times. We moved once into London, near London for a while, and then up to the north of England. I think I was around about five. And they were my first early memories of family. It wasn't until now, over the last year in particular, my brother and I have become particularly close. Not that we ever fell apart, but we've obviously through things have changed a lot over the last year, unfortunately. And now I think we're pretty close, which is nice. It's fantastic. My sister came along a lot later. You know, 5 years is a big difference when you're that young. So she was just a sort of thing on the side that Mum and Dad were seemed quite keen on. The world has always been close. Everyone's close to Jane. Everyone loves Jane. Dad unfortunately split when I was about 20, but they've always been great parents to me, both in different ways. Dad separated and we hung around with Mum, so obviously relationships there were a little different. But there was always plenty of love in the house, that's for sure. I think it's important to just remember that I've been driven by her for so many years about how strong she is. Mm. And how much I have gained from her strength. She's always been there, she's always been strong, always held things together, even when she had a difficult time with the breakup with her father. You know, the family were there going through a tough time, but she was always, always just doing the right thing, toughing it out, and I'm really, really proud of her. Football, cricket, rugby, English, French, more football, tennis, cricket. Just like every kid when I was young, very early teens, I wanted to be a footballer, but I knew I wasn't good enough, but I wanted to be one. I was really 16 until I realised I wanted to study building. I wanted to be a builder of some kind or involved in the building industry. Don't know if I regret that now or not. Kristen, drunk in a pub in the George in Melbourne. Simple as that. Caught her eye across the floor. She was drunk, I was drunk. I tried to mix in with her friends. It's really romantic, isn't it? And I chased her the next day to her work. I knew she was working at the Alfred Hospital. She just gave that away. It was part of my training regime at the time. I was out on a 25 kilometre run, so Mr. Idiot here decides to run into emergency and talk to her and say hi, you know, when could we go out? But she didn't initially, she fobbed me off. Can't understand why, because I look like an idiot, that's why. But I chased her down for a while, and eventually, after trying so hard, she eventually came round. I think that was the long and short of that. Yeah, I did some chasing. It paid off for me, probably not for her. It's fantastic. We have to say she's been through so much. And we have to get a bit sad in some ways here because it's a difficult time in our lives and has been for, you know, some time, particularly now, and everybody knows why, so. But she is the rock. And I'm not going to cry, but she's just been everything to me. And she's the one reason that I'm still here in this conversation, because I wouldn't be without her, quite simply, after everything we've been through, mentally and physically. We've had our moments on the way, no, I don't like everybody else, but right now, you know, this is just all this period of our lives has pulled us closer together. I think she'll agree with that. If she does, I'm in trouble. Don't blame her for walking. I love her. She's just fantastic in every single way. Yeah. And wonders for us. Wonders for you. And my best mate. And, you know, I didn't think I was going to get to see this 50th, and let's hope this still comes out. But the fact we are is just a huge testament to her. Everything that I have is her. my children, without doubt. That's an easy one. Next. A Manchester United moment, when you say a drinking moment. The birth of the kids. Birth of the kids, not one. You don't want to say one more than the other because I can't think of it like that. But without doubt, birth of the children. Nothing really goes close. Yeah, that's a pretty easy one. The roller coaster ride, yeah. Or just a roller coaster, erratic. Nothing's ever simple with me, unfortunately. I've tried to make it that way, but nothing's ever been simple. Sorry, everybody. A roller coaster. I'd like to think they thought I was a good mate, really. You know, everyone has their wishes, don't they? They want to put on their gravestone, all that sort of stuff. But, I just like to think I was a good mate, and a good dad, and a good husband. You know, whatever that may be. In their eyes, it's good enough. Importance of friends, family. The lack of importance of money. Importance of health. In whichever way that might be, just looking after yourself. Taking a bit of time to smell the roses, if you like. You know, knowing when to slow down a bit. That's coming in the later years for obvious reasons. Appreciating what you've got. And just to appreciate the people who love you. That's good enough. Well, until recently, the advice I would give them would have been great advice. So if any advice I think will be worth listening to would be only the advice I can give them now, because I was just never ready for anything until it really happened. That makes sense. Like I had Charlie at 42, 43, and I had Charlie. What advice can you give anyone about being a father? And I wasn't ready until I had Charlie to give that advice. I mean, now I think I've learned a hell of a lot in the last couple of years, but that's been brought on by, unfortunately, brought on by something that's made me change a few things and made me more aware of things through actually, unfortunately, being ill, which is a sad way to learn, but I guess a lot of us might take something from that. And I hope they do. I hope they do realise that we are very lucky to be here. And that's really all I would say to everybody. Anytime, the advice I'll be is just make the best of what you've got. Because sometimes something might just happen. And it might not be you. It might not be you. It might be somebody else. But you just take everything what you can. When you can. And I don't think anything can compare with that. For unfortunate reasons. We're not going to be sad about it, because it's put some real positives about that. About the relationship and learning about what life has to offer. It can be really shitty sometimes, but if you can take something from it, then pass it on. But I think it's only now I have the right to actually say that. Before that, it was just whatever it may be. But even then, I wish I'd known things were more important to just take a breath. And enjoy those things. That's a 50-year-old talking.
Yeah.
There's a few things. One thing. Take your time to decide. It's more, but really one thing is, take your time. Enjoy the presence, enjoy that moment. Much less erratic. to do some of the things I said I should do, i.e. take a bit more time. And look, I still make decisions on the spot. That's just me, you know, whatever it may be. And I still do some silly things that people just shake their heads at. But again, that's just me. But generally, just I think I would just take that little extra breath before I make a few decisions in what I do. We think about others just a little bit more than I have. I don't think I'm really selfish. I'll probably have my moments and I'll get some laughs. But yeah, I think I'd like to sort of just flatten things out a little bit on that graph that I was telling you about. Not too many downsides on a graph. It's more like that rather than that. It's just sometimes you just shake your head with me. I know.
Just to kiss your cunny hair. That was honey hair. And hold you close and hold you like a child. Love heals everything.
Kill all of you. I had no idea this was happening. What can I say? There is nothing to say. They're fantastic. They give and they give and they give, and we keep taking. So keep it going. God knows, I'm friends have been just amazing. Everything's a little bit different, not from just being 50, but you know, because of what's happening in my life physically at the moment. So it's a little bit different to others. But you know what, when the chips are down, family and friends, peace. You know, fantastic. I can't say enough. I really can't. And they know that too. Yeah. Feel the love. Yeah, I'm very lucky. We're very lucky.